Just have a couple of questions for you. If you've had enough time to take a look at the organization,
yep.
Think about this for a minute, and I'll even turn the camera. Mm-hmm. What three positions do you think are critical to the success of the Royals internally?
The three critical parts to our organization at the Reading Royals, probably at the top of the list would be our head coach, Larry Corville, right now. The aspects that he handles, the talent scouting that he does, and the team that he's able to present and put on ice year after year is second to none, in my opinion. And in all honesty, I think it's a travesty that he didn't get Coach of the Year this year. Second would probably be our marketing director. Head of marketing has to go a long way. It encompasses more than just marketing publicly and doing advertising in the community, but it's heavy on the in-game experience, the game ops, as we call it. I think that's going to be critical to really tying the fans in and getting the fans more involved. And then second to that would need to be the director of sales, the people that are most in touch with our client base, our ticket holders, our liaison to our fan base, which is the lifeblood of the company.
Looking external for a bit, what peers did you view as the model that you want to emulate, either in the AHL or the ECHL?
Well, growing up a hockey fan, I always followed the Philadelphia Flyers. And the experience that I've always gotten every time I go there, every game I've gone there since I can remember as a little boy, to now where they are at the Wells Fargo Center, that atmosphere that they create there, it's electric, it's static. When you walk in the building, you can feel it. That is an ambiance and an environment that I think we need to create here to really provide that value to our fan base and to expand our fan base.
Okay. Now, can you pick three external organizations or positions that really impact the success of the Reading Royals?
The three organizations that I think are going to be instrumental in getting us where we want to be and where we need to be would be first probably the ECHL. We need to lean heavily on the experience from the commissioners. The ECHL headquarters is just in Princeton, New Jersey. It's not a very far drive from here. We need to rely heavily on their expertise, the information they have, the education that they provide, not just for myself to get acquainted with the league, but for our staff members to get the best training that they can get so we can get the most out of them. Second would be SMG and the authority, the people that own the building and operate the building. We need a true partnership there to be able to deliver that game experience that I talk about. Working with them on building improvements in the atmosphere and the staff that they provide will go a long way in really taking the game to another level, so to speak. Third would be organizations like GREP and GRIP, economic partnership groups in the Reading area to help team up and really turn Reading into a place to be, improving the nightlife, improving the shopping scene down there, and making Reading a destination to be both before and after a game, not just to come to the game and leave right afterwards, but to stay and really stabilize the economy in Reading.
Okay, with the limited amount of time you've had, what assets do you see as underutilized within the organization? And they can be physical assets or human resource assets.
That's a very good question. I think the team that we have, the administrative team in particular, as a whole, is incredible. The time and the commitment they make and they give to the team. You know, a lot of people don't realize that during a game week, when we have three games at home, they're working 60 or 70 hours. They work on a lot of long hours, a lot of days. And everyone that's in the position is there because they have a great skill set. And I think they've been very spread thin, so they haven't really been able to use or maybe bring to surface all the good qualities and characteristics they have. But I think with the right resources and bringing in some additional help, they'll be able to go to the next level that I know that they're capable of.
The Reading Royals have a relationship, a contract relationship with the Hershey Bears and the Washington Capitals.
That's right.
Have they been of any? Have they been part of what you've been trying to do to assimilate the what is the Reading Royals?
Not yet. Because we came in at the crunch time of the seasons for all the hockey teams while they were trying to do a playoff push, there was very limited correspondence going back and forth. We have great relationships with both the Capitals and the Hershey Bears. They've opened their doors to us to have some insight to what they do. The Hershey Bears, I mean, their fan base is well established, you know, they have a very loyal fan base, and they pull out great numbers in Hershey.
2,000 more than their closest competitor in the AHL.
It's incredible, yes. And they've been able to do it year after year. But we plan on using those relationships and expanding on those as well.